So, let's look at it again. What is our problem? Our problem is our perceptual ideas of the energy that flows from the friction that is existent between ourselves as separate personalities. Within that, we create an idea of what life is, and we manage it through systems called laws and morality and beliefs. Within that, we then create a digital world which is existent in the mental, while we disregard what is real in the physical. And we have thus no value we give to the physical, but yet we fear to lose our mental self. That mentality has created the world the way it is today. That is our problem. That is the point that must be stopped. Not the physical. The physical reality is pretty cool. Our mental reality is pretty fucked up. I imagine as the consequential outflow of you when you die as a mental self is that you no longer exist from the physical reality's point of view, and you become nothing more than a thought. The outflow of what you have become. And then you become a thought of a thought, and a thought of a thought of a thought. The average human being today exists as less than their own thoughts. That's why their thoughts have the power inside their self, inside the mind, to question them. That's why if you have a conversation with yourself in your mind, where your thoughts have the capacity to reduce you to a physical experience of fear or anxiety or feeling less than, then you are less than your thoughts. Pretty screwed up, delusional existence that is now placed within the fascinating context that apparently you have choice to be like this. The choice to be like this is existence within your mental projection of yourself, within which you have an holographic experience of superhero, for instance, where you are Superman within your own mental projected self, where you can do anything because it does not impact the physical. Common sense is existent within the physical. That which is the commonly sensed between all physical parts to support itself. Now imagine that our very nature in this world, the way nature operates, is now a manifestation of our digital self, our mental projected self. And yet we have lost contact completely with the physical, which is why slowly but surely most of the physical that was here is busy dying, is becoming extinct, just as we are becoming extinct. We are becoming extinct as a real being. And in that we become only at the end a thought, a projected digital self, which has no existence in reality whatsoever. And then we are screwed. You can't trust any of that, because can you trust your mind? You can't trust your mind, because your mind will form opinions and will be impacted by a singular energy source. So if you are two beings communicating, you are at high alert, the other one is high alert, you're throwing opinions at each other, and out of that try and form an alliance, or you create a war of minds, and accordingly you manifest your experience. And a being can say one word or move in one way, and you'll immediately go, what are they really saying? Are they mocking me? Oh, they're trying to convince me here. I will not agree. Multiple ways you're using your projection, but none of it is real, because it's not real in the physical. It's not within the context of what's here. But what has happened is you have taken the physical energy and you have transformed it into a projection of itself which is now a projected energy, and you've become this projected energy, which is basically like just a reflection of light. Not real, it's not the light, it's a reflection of the light. It's the beam that's out there, it's not the actual light. You believe that beam is you, and you're trying to get back to the actual light, which is impossible. Of course, it's streaming forth, you can't get back, you have to stop. And then you have to amalgamate with what is here to really be able to end your illusion. What is more fascinating is that within the context of your self-creation, you have devalued life to such a degree that, have a look, you do not give a shit about anyone in existence and what they are really experiencing at the physical level, that which is real, which is the physical. Therefore, by that very fact, you have given permission for your deletion, for your non-existence, because you disregard everything else as non-existing. And in that single act, you have given permission for your end. Which is accordingly emerging now.